We arrived in Ayr about 8 o'clock. That sign Bowen was telling us to go a bit further, but I was a bit tired. And also we were told that the cyclone was closer to Ayr than it was to Bowen at that stage. That didn't prove to be afterwards. And it was quite quiet. There wasn't much wind at this stage. Hi, this is Weather or Nut. We're in a place where I was looking for some mangoes, and I thought the best place for mangoes is down in Ayr and Bowen. So we're here at the moment searching for mangoes.
Quite still at the moment.
There is some lightning about, so we're just watching that, and we do have some cover too. So it's about 8 o'clock. Actually, it's half past 8 at night, so the cyclone isn't expected to come until about 1 o'clock. Okay, so at this point in time, there's a bit of wind around, but not much. 10, and we have missed the main part of the cyclone,
and there are gusts.
As we started getting closer to Bowen, you could see that there was still a lot of rain around. The cyclone had hit. That was at 11 o'clock last night. They got the eye of the cyclone. So we're
heading
there now.
Into Bowen now, and there's still a lot of rain around.
The rain that was coming down here now that you can see was very heavy once we got down to the actual beach. So we had to wait a little while before the rain passed.
So you experienced the cyclone coming through?
Yes.
Here, yeah. What was it like? Was it very heavy or?
It was windy. The wind sort of picked up over a few hours.
Yeah.
Went through till what, about just after midnight?
The eye came through about
11. About 11-ish, the eye came through.
Okay.
And then she calmed down a bit, and then about, I don't know, about 20 minutes after that, the wind just came through again.
So what, you experienced the eye of
yeah,
it?
Yeah, the eye came right over Bowen,
yeah.
But it wasn't as bad as the previous cyclone.
Yeah,
okay. No, all in all, there's not as much damage done. It's the next one that's coming in that's a problem.
So there doesn't appear to be much flooding in that around at
not
all?
Not around here, we don't flood all that much.
Okay.
The Don River, if you went and had a look at the Don River,
yeah,
you'd probably find that's in flood.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, great. Well, thank you very much.
Yeah. No worries.
Enjoy the rain.
Yeah.
Thank you. Hey mate, doing a good job?
Yeah mate, just starting mate.
Yeah, not much damage at all?
No, a few trees down mate, that's about it.
Cool, okay.
Yeah, the eye came over the town at about 10 to 10 last night, and probably took about 40 minutes to pass over the town. The wind direction shifted from the south-southwest to the northeast. And we're very lucky as a town. I think people were very well prepared. And I am surprised to see so.
Oh, I think they've
made a very good physical preparation this time. It's just a continuation of that. I think there's a lot of media hype at the moment in relation to the second one that's being driven by the events in southeast Queensland and southern media. In the north, we sometimes have to prepare for a couple of cyclones each season, and this one we've got off very lightly with. They say the next one's going to be bigger, but the American weather site at the moment has it coming in just south of Cairns at this particular point in time. But of course it could come anywhere. But I think the main issue for Queensland is just the state is so wet, and any major rain event is going to cause big problems. And, I think that's the real issue that we have at the moment statewide, is just how wet the ground is.
Yeah. How was the rain last night through here? Was that very heavy, or was it the wind?
Yeah, it wasn't terribly heavy, no. But when the rain's horizontal, it's pretty hard to get it in a rain gauge as well. So
that's true.
We had a bit more than was recorded.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good preparations that you've got here, just totally protected the windows?
Yeah, it's mainly just protection from flying objects, rubbish bins or roadwork signs, or it's just to protect the glass. And
it did the job.
It's a good solid building.
Yeah, it did the job.
Yeah, it did the job. It's been doing the job for 30 years.
Okay.
This lot, so anyway.
Yes. Well done.
There's more wind in the rain. That's the way it goes, eh?
Yeah?
Oh, I haven't got much of a mess, so we're lucky really in some ways. Make sure you've got everything battered down and just keep an eye on it. Stay inside and just walk around and make sure everything's still there when you're walking around your house. That's what I did last night. I just walked around, had a look outside, checked my cars, had a look out, come this way, looking around the house. Just checked everything.
Great.
The next one's going to be a beauty,
I guess, it looks like business as usual here now.
Exactly, mate. We're all back to normal again.
Beautiful.
Another few days.
Yeah, okay. Thank you very
much. Thanks, mate. No worries.
Take care. The cyclone has gone through. It's about 8 o'clock in the morning. And business as usual for everybody, it appears. So now in preparation for the next one, I think the main thing is that there's no panic involved. Now, when we're told that there's a cyclone coming through and a possible Category 5, it does instill a lot of fear in a lot of people. So maybe if we downgrade the fear, instead of a Category 5 fear, we downgrade the fear and just prepare. And this is where we're asked to step up. So it's step up time. We were born for these times, so we help each other where we can. Okay, from Bowen this time, right where the eye of the storm was. We stayed in Ayr last night, just north of Bowen, and there was hardly any wind there at all. So it's good. Everyone is fine here. Very minor damage with just some branches down. So everybody take care. Thank you.